Okay, y'all. So today I'm going to show you how to add a nofollow link on your site on WordPress. Okay, so before I get into that, let's talk a little bit about what a nofollow link is. I just did a quick little search, and according to socialmedium.com, a nofollow link or a backlink is a link which does not pass authority onto the website it is linking to. These links do not help in terms of SEO. To make a link nofollow, add the rel nofollow to the code when linking to a website. To sum this up, if you have nofollow in your link, you're not going to get a score from Google saying that, hey, this site is great and you should add on to the authority of that site. It pretty much notes that for whatever reason, you don't want it to get authority from Google. One of the main reasons why I use nofollow links as a blogger is if I'm doing some type of paid link on my site, which could be an affiliate link, a sponsored post I'm doing, either of those things. So in this case, this is a sponsored post that we recently did, and it includes affiliate links. So anything that I'm linking to for this brand, I want to make sure that they are nofollow links. Because they're paying me for it, Google says that they shouldn't get credit on their website for having this link. So how do you do this? If you have the most updated version of WordPress and you have Gutenberg, they have the technology already on WordPress for you to do this very easily. What you want to do is find the phrase that you want to put a link in. In this case, I'm going to put a link on Diet Direct. I'm going to highlight Diet Direct, and I'm going to hit the little hyperlink button here. What you do next is you grab your URL, go ahead and paste that in there, and you'll notice that there are a few little buttons you can select. Since this is a paid affiliate link, I'm going to go ahead and select the search engine should ignore this link, mark as nofollow. Because this is also a sponsored link, I'm going to select that one as well, just so that Google knows. And anytime I'm linking out to a website that's not my own, I'm going to open it in a new tab. So I actually checked all three of these boxes. I'm going to go ahead and hit the link so it knows that it's ready to go. And it is going to be treated differently from other links on my site. And that's it. That is how you add a nofollow link to an article on your website in WordPress.